From this lecture, we will start transformer. The transformer is sometimes referred to as the backbone of the electrical system. AC system is favored over the DC system for the electric power generation, transmission and distribution because the voltage level can be easily adjusted with the help of a transformer. AC system has been adopted for generation, distribution and transmission and the use of electrical power as a result of development of the transformer. The transformers have allowed long distance transmission of electrical energy without considerable power loss. When it comes to transmission, high voltages are necessary due to the economic consideration, but when it comes to the utilization of electricity, low voltages are necessary due to the safety consideration. The utilization of the transformer is unavoidable in order to accomplish the conversion of the voltage to the voltage that is required, which also allows the amount of loss to be reduced and guarantees the safer operation of the system. Because the transformer do not contain any moving parts and have a structure that is both rugged and long-lasting, transformers requires relatively minimal maintenance. And they also have a very high efficiency, reaching up to the 99% in some cases. The transformer is an important component of the electrical system. As a consequence of this, it is accurate to say that a transformer is a backbone of the power system. Definition. A transformer is basically a static device which transfers AC electrical power from one circuit to another at the same frequency by following the principle of Faraday's electromagnetic induction. It is an electrical device that can change the voltage and current but keeps the power constant in a circuit. By change, it means that transformer takes the high voltage electricity with a small current and changes it into a low voltage electricity with a large current, or it can take low voltage electricity with a large current and changes it to a high voltage electricity with a small current, but the power remains constant in both of the cases. The major uses of an electrical transformer include for the purpose of adjusting voltage and current levels in the electric power systems, as an impedance matching device for the purpose of achieving maximum power transfer in the low power electrical and control circuits. It also acts as a coupling device in electronic circuits. It also performs the isolation of one circuit from the another, since the primary and secondary of the transformer are not electrically connected. For the purpose of voltage and current measurements, and these transformers are known as instrument transformers. It can also immediately step up the voltage at the site of the power generation before the transmission and distribution can take place. Transformers are extensively used in AC power system because of the following reasons. Electrical energy can be generated at the most economic level from 11 to 33 kilovoltage. Enhancing the generated voltage to a high voltage or to extra high voltage EHV, voltage greater than 230 kV, or even ultra high voltage UHV, voltage greater than 750 kV. To meet the power transmission requirements in order to reduce the losses and enhance the transmission capacity of the lines. The transmission voltage is stepped down in many stages for distribution and utilization for domestic, commercial and industrial consumers. Let's see the basic configuration of a transformer. For the basic configuration of the transformer, every transformer configuration is equipped with an iron core laminated with steel bands. A block diagram of the transformer can be given by: from this block diagram, a transformer has two sides or section. Primary side where the input is provided and the secondary side where the output is generated and the load is connected. If voltage and current in the primary side is V1 and I1 and the voltage and current in the secondary side is V2 and I2, then if the secondary voltage V2 is higher than the primary voltage V1, then the transformer is known as a step-up transformer. If the secondary voltage V2 is lower than the primary voltage V1, then the transformer is known as a step-down transformer. If the primary voltage V1 and the secondary voltage V2 are equal, then the transformer is said to be 1-to-1 ratio transformer. Transformers that are rated as 1-to-1 transformer are frequently utilized in the process of electrically isolating two distinct portions of a circuit. Depending on how the transformer is connected, it can either act as step up or step down converter. This versatility applies to all the transformers. Let's see the classification of the transformer. The transformers can be classified based on the position of the windings, transformation ratio, based on the uses, supply, cooling and core medium. According to the position of the windings concerning the core, they are of two types: core type transformer and shell type transformer. According to the transformation ratio, or the number of turns in the windings, the transformer are of three types: step up, step down, and center type transformer. On the basis of supply, transformer are of two types: single phase transformer and three phase transformer. The types of services performed by the transformer can classify the transformer into two domains. In the power domain, they are of three types: power transformer, distribution transformer, and instrument transformer. Instrument transformer can also be divided into three types: current transformer, potential transformer, and auto transformer. In the electronic domain, the transformer are of two types: audio output transformer and pulse transformer. On the basis of coolings, transformer are of seven types: air natural or self air cooled or dry transformer, air force or air blast type transformer, oil natural transformer, oil natural and air force transformer, oil force and air force transformer, oil natural water force transformer, and oil force and water force transformer. On the basis of core medium, transformer are of four types: ferrite core transformer, iron core transformer, air core transformer, and toroidal core transformer. Let's see the basic configuration of a transformer. The basic configuration of a transformer includes an iron core laminated with the steel bands. A transformer has two sides or section, primary side and secondary side. In the primary side, we have primary winding or primary coil, which have N1 number of turns. Supply or input voltage to the primary winding is V1, and it generates a magnetic flux Φm. Then the self-induced voltage in the primary is equal to E1, and the current in the primary winding is equal to I1. In the secondary side, we have secondary winding or secondary coil when the number of turns is equal to N2. The flux generated in the primary winding will get linked to the secondary winding, and the flux which are not linked to the secondary winding is known as leakage flux. The mutually induced voltage due to the flux linkage in the secondary winding is equal to E2, which is connected across the load, and the current in the secondary winding is equal to I2. Let us understand the working principle of a transformer. The basic principle behind the working of a transformer is the phenomenon of mutual induction between the two windings linked by common magnetic flux. The figure shows the simplest form of a transformer. Basically, a transformer consists of two inductive coils, primary winding and secondary winding. The coils are electrically separated but magnetically linked to each other, and how they are magnetically linked, we will see that in a bit. When the primary winding is connected to a source of alternating voltage, then the alternating flux is generated in the magnetic core, which links both primary and secondary winding. The core provides a magnetic path for the flux to get linked with the secondary winding, and due to this, most of the flux gets linked with the secondary winding, and the flux that are linked with the secondary winding known as useful flux or main flux. The flux which does not get linked with the secondary winding is called leakage flux. As the flux is produced is alternating in nature, because the direction of the flux is continuously changing, the EMF gets induced in both of the winding according to the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. Consequently, the self-induced EMF E1 and the mutually induced EMF E2 are induced in the primary and secondary winding respectively. These EMFs are developed in the phase opposition to the applied voltage V1 as per the Lenz law. The self-induced EMF E1 in the primary is also called back EMF, since it acts in the opposite direction to the applied voltage V1. If the secondary winding is a closed circuit, then mutually induced current flows through it, hence the electrical energy is transferred from primary to the another circuit secondary. The magnitude of induced EMF in a coil depends upon the rate of change of flux linkage. Since the rate of change of flux for both of the winding is same, the magnitude of the induced EMF in primary and secondary will depend upon the number of turns. So primary induced EMF E1 will be proportional to the number of turns N1, and the secondary induced EMF E2 will be proportional to the number of turns N2. When the secondary winding turns N2 is greater than primary winding turns N1, then the transformer is called step-up transformer. On the other hand, if the secondary winding turns N2 is less than the primary winding turns N1, then the transformer is called step-down transformer. Turns ratio. The ratio of primary to secondary turns is called turn ratio. The number of turns in the primary side of the transformer is equal to N1, and the number of turns in the secondary side of the transformer is equal to N2. So the turn ratio is N1 by N2. Now, transformation ratio. The ratio of the secondary voltage to the primary voltage is called transformation ratio. It is represented by K. So K is equal to E2 by U1, which is equal to N2 by N1, since E2 is proportional to N2 and U1 is proportional to N1. Let's see the different characteristics of a transformer. A transformer is a static device, or it has no moving parts. A transformer works on the principle of Faraday's electromagnetic induction. A transformer is a highly efficient device. A transformer is designed to use AC supply and cannot operate on DC. A transformer cannot change the frequency. A transformer keeps the power constant in both sides. A transformer only changes the voltage and current level by keeping the total power constant. A transformer is electrically isolated and magnetically linked. This concludes our discussion for this lecture. In the event that you have any question regarding this presentation, feel free to post them in the comment section, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.